My professor, Dr. Amal Bishlawi, to give me the honor to share in this great scientific conference with my professor and the colleagues, and a special thank to my professor, Dr. Amal. I learned a lot every day from her, not in the scientific hematological issue, but all the life issue, and mainly the ethics in how to deal with the patient. We always talk about hemophilia A, but what about hemophilia B? I'm the lucky speaker because I'm the last speaker in 5 minutes, hemophilia B. I don't talk about the factor, I talk about hemophilia B. You know all that hemophilia A is abnormality in coagulation factor 8, and hemophilia B, the abnormality in coagulation factor 9, and in my presentation, I will focus on what is the difference between hemophilia A and hemophilia B in the pathophysiology and in the complication and the treatment. Etiology, we all know that it's X-linked due to gene mutation, and the gene now play a role in the outcome of every hemophilic patient. Epidemiology, I think hemophilia A more than 80%, 85%, hemophilia B 20% of our cases, also in our clinic, the same percentage. A degree of severity like hemophilia A, as illustrated by Professor Dr. Mona Hamdi, severe with the factor less than 1, moderate the factor 1 to 5, and the mild 5 to 40, and the normal, you know, all the normal, and the most of our hemophilic patient, I think it is moderate hemophilic patient. In inheritance, you all know that X-linked inheritance. But what about the difference between hemophilia A and the hemophilia B? Mainly in the gene mutation. And this gene mutation will affect the arthropathy and the joint affection, as we will see in next. And what about the molecule of factor 8 and factor 9? Factor 9, a large molecule, factor 9, small molecule, factor 8, large molecule, and this will affect the inhibitor formation and the extracellular distribution of this factor. Also, the concentration in the plasma, 0.2 in factor 8, but in factor 9, more concentration because the extracellular distribution represents more than the threefold of the intravascular concentration. As almost the most common symptoms of hemophilia, bleeding into joint, prolonged bleeding from cutting injury, nose bleeding, bruising, and this is the same percentage of bleeding manifestation. This guy is 18 years from one government during dental extraction without preparation, a huge, very huge neck hematoma and throat hematoma up to suffocation. The joint affection in hemophilia A more severe than in hemophilia B. Why? Because the biomarker for bone biology always take the balance between the bone osteoclastic genetic affinity and the osteoblast. That's an imbalance in hemophilia A more than in hemophilia B. So the bone resorption and the bone affection and the bone damage and the articular damage in hemophilia A more severe than hemophilia B, because they found that the one of these biomarkers, the osteopetrogen, is more high level, which is responsible for preservation of the chondral junction and the chondral bone. So the affection of the joint in hemophilia B, even with the same level of the factor like hemophilia A, and the same recurrent of bleeding, is milder than hemophilia B. And also not the joint, also the score, the joint score and the ultrasonographic manifestation of hemophilia B is lesser than hemophilia A. This is due to the biochemical distribution of the bone resorption and the bone formation. What other factor affecting the phenotype and the genotype between hemophilia A and the hemophilia B? The hemophilic variant The level of other procoagulant and anticoagulant and will be illustrated. The inflammatory response that might impact the person's susceptibility to joint damage from bleeding. The non-genetic factor, the level and pattern of activity, the body built, the life of every patient, and the occurrence of trauma. I think this is the most important one, show the difference between hemophilia A and hemophilia B in the Hematologica 2019. What are the causes of the causes for this difference? Mainly the genetic causes. The genetic causes of the hemophilia and the genetic mutation in hemophilia B, the nonsense mutation, the small deletion, which is composed about more than 50% in hemophilia B. And this not associated with margin damage, not associated with inhibitor. Unlike hemophilia A, the large deletion and the nonsense mutation and the null mutation with no endogenous factor composed about more than 60% in hemophilia A. Other than factor, they found that some of the procoagulant like protein C, protein S, and antithrombin are less. This enhance the coagulation and the coagulant factor, giving the hemophilia B milder phenotypic type. Also, the pharmacodynamic and the pharmacoecogenic pattern of the factor 9 in the extracellular distribution and extravascular distribution give long half-life standing of factor 9 and the threefold in the serum, not like factor 9. All these causes, the genetic, the extra distribution, the associated, give milder phenotypic joint affection, bleeding manifestation in hemophilia B than hemophilia A. As Dr. Mona said, that we started 28 years ago by plasma. Now, most of our patients receiving factor 9, recombinant factor 9, not plasma-derived factor 9. It is a recombinant factor 9. And as Dr. Mona, knowing us, the difference between the plasma-derived and the recombinant regarding the purity and the viral safety and which type of viral removal or viral activation in the recombinant factor. This better treatment for our patient and for the hemophilic patient have increased the hemophilic life expectancy and improved the quality of life. What about the World Federation guidelines for treating hemophilia B? For hemophilia B requiring, this is in the guideline 2020, requiring prolonged therapy at high dose, the use of pure recombinant factor 9 is recommended over LPCC. For hemophilia B undergoing surgery, the use of factor 9 is recommended over BCC. For hemophilia B with liver disease, the use of factor 9, pure factor 9, recommended over BCC. For hemophilia, and we will illustrate that, for hemophilia B with previous thrombosis, the use of factor 9. But after giving for any treatment, we should know what is our patient reported outcome, what our response of this treatment, and the meaning of excellent response, good response, moderate response, non-response, and all of you know that. How to calculate the dose? You know that every one international unit of factor 9 raising the plasma level, one international, not like factor 8. So please calculate factor 9 in a correct way and correct dose. This is the World Federation guideline for every site of bleeding. What is the desired level and for how long duration? And so we put our guideline, the Egyptian guidelines by our professor, Dr. Galila and Dr. Amal Bishlawi and the other professor, for our guideline, and I think this is the guidelines also for the insurance, and we update this guide every year and every now. What type of treatment? On-demand treatment, prophylaxis, or optimized prophylaxis? And you know, what the meaning of primary prophylaxis, secondary, tertiary prophylaxis, for the sake of the time, and will not repeat that. But the World Federation guideline recommend prophylaxis is the standard of care for hemophilia A and hemophilia B also. Why? To prevent hemoarthrosis, spontaneous bleeding, breakthrough bleeding, maintain musculoskeletal health, promote quality of life, reduce the joint affection, and increase the progression of bitter joint affection, decreasing the hospital visit and admission. And actually, when the mean hospitalized day of hemophilia in our center, 1.8 day. The prophylaxis should be individualized. The WFHS strongly recommend that such patient on prophylaxis sufficient to prevent the bleeding at all times, but prophylaxis should be individualized. Why? Every patient has a bleeding phenotype, joint status, individual pharmacokinetics, and the patient's self-assessment and preference. So please follow up in a very meticulous way for the outcome of this prophylaxis and which type of prophylaxis and what is the trough level before we think that in 1% trough level of any factor, factor 8 or factor 9, it is okay, but this is not prevent the clinical bleeding. Even the apparent clinical bleeding is zero, but still by ultrasonographic and by radiological, there is still bleeding and still joint affection. So the new guideline to increase the trough level by 3-5% or higher than that. So the prophylaxis is the standard care everywhere for every patient. Which type of prophylaxis? High dose prophylaxis like in hemophilia A, or intermediate as Dr. Mona Hamdi said, or low dose. We will put the prophylaxis regimen hopefully soon for hemophilia B. What about the inhibitor in hemophilia B? Constitute about 1-3% up to 5%. The development is in hemophilia B considered most serious complication as it is associated by severe anaphylaxis and the nephrotic syndrome, usually occur after 10 exposure, not thought to be related to the type of factor anyway, plasma derived or recombinant factor. Why the inhibitor in hemophilia B is lower than in hemophilia A? For non-genetic factor, lower proportion of severe phenotype in hemophilia B compared to hemophilia A, the smaller size and the fewer immunogenic epitope in factor 9, less inhibitor, higher extravasation of extravascular distribution of factor 9. What about the genetic factor? As I said, the missense mutation most common in hemophilia A, not the large mutation or null mutation. So the inhibitor is low risk and low percentage. This is a lot of study comparing the percentage of the and the genotype and the percentage of inhibitor, a lot of studies. This is in Hematologica 2 months ago. What is the comparison between inhibitor in hemophilia A and hemophilia B? The percentage, the frequency of reaction, the anaphylactic reaction in hemophilia B, not in hemophilia A. Yesterday before, we have one patient in our hospital, always has a reaction from the plasma, even sometimes plasma SD, and in the last two infusion with hemophilia, with factor 9, develop allergic reaction. So please, don't give factor 9 in home. Should be in a clinic, should be in a center with very, very close monitoring, as anaphylaxis sometimes and always leading to death, Inhibitor screening like in hemophilia A, and there is intensive exposure more than 5 days, if they fail to respond to adequate clotting, if there is any reaction or nephrotic reaction or undergoing major surgery, please don't forget to do inhibitor screening, even in hemophilia B, before any surgical maneuver. There is a cross link between the genotype inhibitor anaphylaxis, this is in hemophilia, anaphylactic reaction to factor 9 replacement therapy are life-threatening. They always in a families with null mutation than in families with missense mutation. So it is better to do genetic mutation before starting any treatment in hemophilia B. But this is not available in the insurance. Hemophilia B and inhibitor, the World Federation Hemophilia recommend monitoring, meticulous monitoring in the initial infusion in a clinic or hospital setting. The World Federation recommend the screening for nephrotic syndrome in any patient hemophilia B with allergic reaction, recommend to treat acute bleeding, but it is again by factor 9, but against using LBCC because it contains some of factor 9. And if any patient have history of allergic reaction or anaphylaxis and giving LBCC will develop anaphylaxis and severe allergic reaction. The inhibitor management in low responder, the same in the low responder treated by factor 9, but decrease the interval. But if there is any reaction, you should to give bypassing agent the factor 7. For high responder antibiotic, for high responder inhibitor, you should to give recombinant factor 7 prefer. Don't give PCC because it contains factor 9 and will lead to severe reaction. So this is the protocol of treatment of inhibitor in hemophilia B, the low responder factor 9, the high responder factor 7, in monitoring the activity and the thromboelastography not done in the insurance. Inhibitor and the surgery, if there is any patient with hemophilia B and having inhibitor, in the low responder inhibitor, you should to give factor 9 more frequent than the usual, and in the high inhibitor level undergoing surgery, you should to give bypassing agent factor 7 with a very, very, very meticulous close monitoring for thrombosis. Regarding the surgery, as Dr. Muhammad Talat said, we have a multidisciplinary team. Before any surgery, we do the inhibitor, we assess the factor, we assess the clinical condition of the patient, and we put a plan for a surgical maneuver, the time, the procedure, the status of the hemostasis, and we attend in every operation, we attend intraoperative for excellent hemostatic activity. This is done in the insurance in our hospital. This patient, hemophilia A, with pseudotumor of tibia, and we did a bone graft and a scrow with a good hemostasis. This one, hemophilia B, with pseudotumor of the femur. This patient, 14 years, weighing more than 120 kilo, obesity, used a lot of factor 9, and this is the screw and the nail for correction of the fractured femur. This one with a good hemostasis by using factor 9. Very good hemostasis. Thank you a lot.